Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Viewers all over the world, wherever you are, peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. As we promised last week, we're going to be answering questions that Orientalists and, apologists from all angles have been levering against Islam. They're trying to make Islam look bad. Sometimes they quote Quranic ayah and without any giving the before and the after texts. They just quote the text and then they present it as if they know what exactly they're talking about. I mean, in Islam, there is a science called Asbab al-Nuzul. This science deals with each and every verse that came to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the context. In what sense does it make? But these apologists or, atheists and agnostics, they just quote the Quranic ayah. They don't speak no English. They don't understand what Arabic is all about. They just read in the English version on internet and then they present to mankind. That is definitely not the case. So if you want to know certain verses in the Quran, in fact, all the Quranic verses, you have to make sure you approach a Muslim scholar who specializes on the Quranic exegesis. I mean, you're not just going to come and pull up any verse and then start to make any, chaotic, explanation about it as if you are an authority. No, you're not. Today, what I'm going to be dealing with that is the Quran chapter 4, verse 34, where according to them, they say the Quran have given the men mandate to beat up the women. That is so very sad. Who does that? But that's what they do without regard to the context and the explanation of what that verse actually means. That is not the case. Marriage in Islamic context is a means of tranquility, a means of protection, repose, and comfort. That's what marriage in Islam actually means. Elsewhere in the Quran, Allah said, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. And among the son of Allah is that He creates from among you mates, men and women, and He placed love in your hearts, and then mercy, so that you will attain tranquility and peace amongst yourself. So where or what is the question? Rather, where is the question of beating up a woman? No, that is not the case. If you look at the context, it is so very sad that they keep quoting this Quran to make Islam look so bad. Let me give you an example. If you have, your child or your children in the house, if they misbehave, what do you do to them? Psychologists who specialize on child, upbringing, you could scold him a little bit. I mean, you're not going to beat him up in such a way that he's going to look so bad or face bruises and everything. Show your anger, right? Don't you do that? Don't you get disciplined sometimes when you do something wrong? That is exactly what it means. It doesn't mean to beat them up and blow them and kick them and give them blue eye and black eye. That's not what it means. But the pagans, which I call the pagans, the atheists to me are pagans. And the problemic today, those who think they specialize on the Quranic exegesis, which they don't, they make it seem like that's what the case. No, it is unfortunately, whatever they're saying doesn't make sense and it doesn't add up at all. In the United States, in Germany, in France, in Africa, in all nations, if you get into, a demarcational border problem, don't you fight amongst yourself? Sometimes you have to fight to protect yourself or to protect your property. If somebody matches up to you in your house trying to steal something, a robbery, don't you fight? You fight. Sometimes you have to fight to protect certain interests. War is strategy. In order to win the war, you have to master the weapon of your enemy. So we go to war sometimes. We don't want the war, but we have to go to war so that we create peace. That's exactly what it is. So if women misbehave, Allah gave us women, and sometimes they do certain things. Men and women are not the same on certain level. Sometimes they do certain things and we begin to question that. It doesn't mean beat her up, like scold her a little bit. But before you do that, talk to her. If she doesn't stop, make sure you don't sleep on the same bed with her. If she doesn't stop, tell her parents, let's have a discussion. Let's talk about this. If still it didn't work, you can scold them a little bit. The messenger said, it's like taking, the lower side of the handkerchief and whip her like this, or it's like taking a single thread and to kind of like slap them like that to show your anger. It doesn't mean to beat them up, but this is how they make it look. Definitely, it is a fraud quotation. It doesn't make any sense. No rational human being, more especially Islam, which came to give women their liberation, to give women their right, When Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam began to receive the revelation in the Arabian Peninsula, women are like nothing. They were like slaves. You know, a son can inherit his mother, and on and on and on and on. Women are count as inheritance. They don't get no inheritance. They're like properties and all that kind of stuff. Islam came and stopped all this thing. And today, so very unfortunately, those who are trying to find a fault against Islam, they begin to bring all this thing. I'm not going to get into other religions and quote certain verse and let you understand that this is what they do. No, I'll leave it at that. So definitely, you should try to understand what the lexical meaning of each and every verse that comes to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the Quran. أقول قول هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وأستغفر الله إنه هو الغفور الرحيم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.